Hello everyone. In previous video, I have explained that how a company can record journal entries while for future and reissue of shares. Today, again the same topic I am going to repeat, I am going to explain you in different conditions. Basically, we feel difficulties while passing journal entry at the time of forfeiture and reissue of share in case of oversubscription and premium. So today I am going to explain you how journal entry can be recorded if there was oversubscription, shares were issued at premium and it is going to be forfeit and reissued. So for this, first of all, we have to take an example for this. So just imagine that Z Limited issued shares for 20,000. So issued share 20,000 of rupees 10 each at a premium of rupees 3. Let's see. One example. Company issued 20,000 shares as the rate of rupees 10 at a premium of 3, which are payable three on application, six on allotment, two on first call, two on final call. See, 10 plus 3, 13, 69 to 11 to 13. See, this is the rate of amount which a company can receive from the applicant. But on the closing date of application has been received for 45,000 shares. See, applications were received for 45,000 shares. It means 25,000 extra application has been received. Then in this situation, we have to calculate that applied and allotted. See, as question is saying, or in this example, to the applicant of 10,000 allotted nil means it is going to be rejected. So it is going to be rejected at 10,000. Rate of application is 3, so rejected amount is 30,000. And question is saying, pro rata allotment was made to the remaining applicant is 35,000. Allotted share is how much? We can allot 20,000. It means 15,000 application is going to be adjusted. So adjusted amount share is 15,000, rate is 3, so 45,000 we are going to adjust. This is the treatment of oversubscription. But let's see what will happen if there will be calls in arrears. So just see, I am going to make here about calls in arrears. See, according to information given, Mr. Manoj, who has allotted 1,000 shares, failed to pay allotment and first call money. Means there was an arrear on allotment and first call money. His share were forfeited immediately. So let's see how to calculate the amount of arrear on allotment and first call. As we know, this adjusted amount is going to be adjusted with allotment, and there was earlier an allotment. It means some amount of Manoj is also going to adjust, so that we have to calculate firstly allotted share of Manoj is given 1000 allotted share. Then we have to calculate applied, how much he has applied. So see what rules I have explained about it in previous class, in previous video also, that if we need to calculate applied, then applied will be up and allotted will be down. It means 35,000 divided by 20,000, then it is coming 1750 shares. It means he has applied for 1750 shares, but company has allotted 1000 shares. It means there is a surplus amount of his on 750 shares as the rate of rupees 3, so 2250. So how to arrear? Let's check arrear on allotment. Allotted share is 1000, and we know that on allotment premium is added, 3 capital, 3 premium. Let's make a change in it. Let it 5 only. 5 only, then it will be 3, then capital will be 2. So here in allotment there is a capital and security premium reserve. So on 1000 capital is 2 and on 1000 premium is 3. So 2000 capital and 3000 premium. These are the amount which are required. But out of this surplus is 2250. So firstly this surplus will be adjusted from capital. So 2000 adjusted from capital and 250 will be adjusted with premium. It means on allotment there was arrear for premium only 2750. After that we can calculate arrear on first call. So there is capital only 1000 share, it is 3, so it will be 3000. See, this is the notes for this over subscription only. After that this server will forfeited and reissue. So let's see how to pass journal entry. In previous class I have told you how to prepare journal entry if cash book we have to maintain. Today I am going to solve for complete entry, means no need to maintain cash book, all the entry we have to record. So let's see how to pass journal entry. These are the space for working note. Now we can pass journal entry. Let's see first for. See, directly I am going to pass journal entry. You have to write in a proper column with proper narration, and I hope that you all understand that how, what are the column of journals and what will be the narration of it. I have explained already in previous class. So firstly entry for bank 2, or you can write equity, it is equity share application account. How to get the amount? Total application received for 45,000, rate of application is 3, so 1,35,000 is total amount. And then equity share application account debit to equity share capital account to, for adjustment we have to write equity share allotment account, and for rejected share we have to write to bank account. In capital we write only those shares which we can allot. So allotted share is 20,000. So 20,000 rate is 3, then it is 60,000. And see, rejected amount is 30,000, so in bank 30,000. Adjusted is 45, so it is 45,000. So 1,35,000 total is coming equal. It means it is right. So this is the entry for first installment. Go to the second one, means share allotment. Then equity share allotment account debit to equity share capital account to security premium reserve account. See amount. Now you having share only 20,000, capital is 2 and 20,000 premium is 3. Then 40,000 capital, 60,000 premium, total amount required it is 1 lakh. After that, see, when we are going to receive the amount, so bank account debit to equity share allotment account. What will be the amount? Amount needed 1 lakh. Let's see, it is 1 lakh minus already received 45,000, means adjusted amount, minus 45,000, and arrear on allotment 2,750. So 2,750 will also minus here, then means 48, then 52,250. This is the amount which you will receive at the time of allotment. Again, similarly for first call also, share first call, it is equity share. Equity share first call account debit to equity share capital account. Amount is what? 20,000, rate is 3, then it will be 60,000. And after that, amount what you will receive, bank account debit to share or to equity share first call. What will be the amount? We need 60,000 and arrear on first call 3,000. It means that 60,000 minus 3,000, then we will receive the 57,000. And as I have told you, as he failed to pay the amount of first call also, director decided to forfeit his shares. Then let's see the journal entry for forfeiture of shares. As I have told you yesterday also, equity share capital account debit. He hold 1,000 share, and as the rate of called up it was, see, we have called till first call. It means 3,2,5,3,8, excluding premium. Remember, while we are writing equity share capital account debit and we are going to calculate the amount of called up, then for capital only, because it's a share capital, then we need the amount of capital 3,2,5,3,8. Or you can say final call was not made 2 rupees. So out of 10, 2 is not called. So called up will be 8. So 1000 into 8, it will be 8,000. And amount of premium not received. Yes, of course you can see arrear on premium. It is 2750. Then security premium reserve account debit, it is 2750. डोंट मल्टीप्लाई हियर 1000 इंटू थ्री नॉट 3000 बिकॉज 200 अमाउंट ऑफ प्रीमियम यू हैव रिसीव्ड. सो एरियर ऑन प्रीमियम इज 2750 ओनली टू शेयर अलॉटमेंट अकाउंट. एरियर ऑफ टोटल एरियर इज 2750 टू शेयर फर्स्ट कॉल अकाउंट. वी कैन राइट हियर इक्विटी. ओके एंड ऑन फर्स्ट कॉल इट इज 3000. सो द बैलेंस विल बी ट्रांसफर टू शेयर फॉर फ्यूचर अकाउंट. सी 8 to 10,750 माइनस 5750 देन 5000 अमाउंट विच वी आर गोइंग टू फॉरफिट. सो फॉरफिटेड अमाउंट इज 5000 एंड लेट दैट कंपनी हैज रीइश्यूड दीज शेयर्स. रीइश्यूड व्हाट इज रेट ऑफ रीइश्यूड. सी आउट ऑफ 1000 शेयर 600 शेयर्स वर रीइश्यूड एट रुपीज सेवन एज पेड अप रुपीज 8 मीन्स 8 रुपए का शेयर 7 रुपए में मीन्स 1 रुपीज डिस्काउंट दैट विल बी एडजस्टेड फ्रॉम शेयर फॉर फ्यूचर. देन सी बैंक अकाउंट डेबिट. सो 600 शेयर्स वर रीइश्यूड एट द रेट ऑफ 7 सो इट इज 4200 एंड देर इज ए लॉस और डिस्काउंट. So that will go in share for future account. It is 600 into 1. Remember there will be a problem. If question will say that as fully paid up, then loss will be 3. Because fully paid up means face value of share is 10 and reissued at 7. So loss will be 3. But here it is saying issued at 7 as paid up rupees 8. So we have to compare from 8 to 7 means 1 rupees loss, then 600 loss to equity share capital account, it is 4800. Now the last thing, last entry, share for future account debit to capital reserve. Last entry, but there is a problem that how to get the amount of it. I can show you here in a notes for capital reserve. See formula for forfeited amount it is 5000, reissued share 600, forfeited share 1000, then it will be 3000. When you solve it, then it is 3000 minus discount means this share for which I debited 600. So 2400 is the amount which we have to transfer into capital reserve. So this is the typical one, you can say typical one, because all the topic oversubscription, arrear, premium, all topic has been covered in this question, in this example. So I hope you all have understand this, and this will help you to solve other problem. Tomorrow I will show you that how to pass journal entry when question will ask to forfeit shares. Only we have to pass journal entry for forfeiture and reissue of shares in different types of cases. Okay. So till today, you all should try to solve various questions from your textbook, from this topic or previous topic or any type, because all the topic I have explained. Normal means chapter is over today only. So some special type of transaction in which we have to pass journal entry for forfeiture of shares only, we will solve tomorrow. I will show you tomorrow that how to solve entry only for forfeiture and reissue of shares. Okay. So you all are requested to practice so many questions from this chapter, because this chapter is very important for your board exams. Okay. So keep trying, and whatever problem you are facing, tell me tomorrow. I will explain that. Okay?